Thank you for joining us here today. We'll be taking some questions now. That's all we have time for today. Thank you.
Well, what a game we have in store for you today. The hype has been building all week and the fans are pouring into the stadium. The tension palpable. Stay tuned, we'll have all the action for you live on EA TV. Hi everyone, it is an absolutely splendid day for football and we're looking forward to the game.
Thank you.
Derek Ray here on the commentary box, joined as always by former Arsenal and England fullback Lee Dixon. And what we have for you is live action from the Championship. It's Preston North End and they take on Blackburn Rovers.
Yeah, thanks as always, Derek. It's a pleasure to be here. Anticipating a really good game today. The atmosphere is great. Certainly buzzing from the spectators' point of view as we head towards kickoff. Hopefully, we won't be disappointed.
Well, he was in the right place to intercept. He'll be delighted to have won the ball, having made that difficult challenge. Well, let's run the rule over the Preston North End starting 11. Are they going to forge ahead? And a fine stop. Let's join Alan McInally because I'm hearing there's been a goal in the Leeds United match. Alan.
It's a goal for Leeds United. 8 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks as ever for the update, Alan. Joe Rothwell. Brown. Oh, just couldn't keep the ball. A chance for him on the flank. Barkhuizen. And he takes it on. That will give them quite the lift. An early opening goal lead.
Well, you always want to start quickly, and there's certainly a quick start there. What a finish.
So the match has restarted. 1-0 here. Goal has been scored in the Fulham game. Alan McInally can tell us a bit more.
It's a goal for Fulham. 16 minutes played, 1-0.
Oh, that's an interesting pass. Firing it in. The goalkeeper relatively untroubled.
Yeah, he's not going to let that one in, Derek.
Well, we had to interrupt Alan McInally just then. Apologies for that. To clarify, Fulham have scored in that game. And their lead stands at 1-0 presently. He has time to play it over. Well, that's one for them to pursue. Pearson. Gomez. Top class defending. I believe there's been a change to the scoreline in the Brentford match. Alan McInerney can tell us more.
It's a second goal for Brentford. 28 minutes played, 2-0.
Alan McInerney with his finger on the pulse.
The hosts are struggling in terms of possession, but they won't mind. They're winning this game. And why? Because they're...
He's got to score! Well, he had designs on a double, but the goalkeeper wasn't having it.
Well, he did better than the first time, the goalkeeper. What a save that is.
Useful ball towards the back post this time. Well, he couldn't quite keep the header down.
Well, it was the pace on the cross. Sometimes with that much power on the cross, just cushion it, otherwise it goes over.
Corey Evans now. Armstrong. Armstrong. Bradley Dack. And very deftly cut out. Good-looking sequence. Must score! They've gone and scored again. They're doing everything in their power to make sure they're not pegged back. So 2-0 now. And news of a goal in the Luton Town match. Alan McInerney can tell us more.
It's the second goal for the visitors. 42 minutes played. 2-0.
Thank you, Alan McInerney. Can they switch to an even higher gear? Can they convert? And the keeper taking care of the situation. And the referee has added on 2 minutes of stoppage time. Fisher. Smuggled away. Well, truth be told, he's only had a very limited influence on the game. What have you made of his performance, Lee?
Well, he's been a little bit safe today. He's not risked anything. That's not good enough. That's why they're behind in this game. Sometimes you've just got to take a little chance. Go for it.
And he did what he had to do defensively. And the managers will now deliver their half-time team talks. We're at the end of... Plenty to consider based on what we've seen so far as the second half begins. Well, the pass not finding its target. He's going for... Oh, surely! Still possibilities. Well, good defending. Clattered out of there. Brown. That would be meat and drink to most goalkeepers.
Yeah, goalkeeper fully in control there.
And Alan McInerney can fill us in on a goal that's been scored at the KCOM Stadium. Alan.
It's a goal for Hull City. 51 minutes played. 1-1.
Thanks as ever for the update, Alan. The thrills and spills of Championship action. Join us for this one live on EA TV. It's Preston North End against Charlton Athletic.
Yeah, game after game, the season is relentless, but players just love to play. Give them a game any day of the week. That should be a belter.
Bennett. And a chance for him on the flank. Speculative ball fired to the near post. It's still alive. Just looking ahead to another game coming up for you from the Championship, live on EA TV. It's Blackburn Rovers facing Sheffield Wednesday. Can he take advantage? Well, that was simply miles off target, dear me.
Oh, close your eyes when you're watching this one. It's horrific.
And news coming through from the Riverside where there's been a goal. Let's find out all about it from Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Middlesbrough. 63 minutes played, 1-1.
Thank you, Alan McInally. Joe Rothwell, given away. And the attack fades out. Tremendous intuition to win it back. Well, it's come down to the final 20 minutes here. Oh, nice work to get past his opponent. Happy to take on the shot. Priority. He was to hang on to the ball, which he did. A goal has been scored in the Fulham game. Alan McInally can tell us a bit more.
It's a second goal for Fulham. 73 minutes played. 2-1.
Many thanks, Alan. They've regained possession. He continues to make hay. And it might be. He's gone for power, but might be regretting that now, Lee.
Oh, my. Why? How? So many questions.
Richard Smallwood to be replaced by number 9, Sam Gallagher.
The visitors have totally controlled possession. However, after that, the coach will be disappointed with what they produced. They need to be a little bit more clinical in front of goal.
Joe Rothwell. Oh, he's given the ball away unnecessarily. Oh, goodness, he was right on top of the situation to get the ball back for his team. Being pressed hard. I understand there's been a goal in the Derby County game. Alan McInally.
It's a third goal for Derby County. It's been scored by Tom Lawrence. The defence were expecting a shot, but he feinted, slipped past the back line, and passed the ball into the corner. 6 minutes remain. 3-1.
Thanks very much, as always, Alan. Possession lost, intercepted. We have entered the final minute of normal time. And the referee has added on 2 minutes of stoppage time. Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change.
Derek Williams coming onto the pitch, number 17.
That's it, the referee brings the action to an end. And a chance for him on the flank.
We just grab a minute of your time for a few questions. Thank you.
When you score goals, you make headlines, and this man is the leading marksman in the league. Does he have another goal in his future today? Hello, everyone. You know, some footballers enjoy a rainy day. Not sure fans always feel that way, but an exciting match in prospect nonetheless. I'm Derek Ray here on the commentary box, and I'm joined for commentary by Lee Dixon. I'm looking forward to bringing you the cut and thrust of the championship. It's Preston North End, and they take on Huddersfield Town. Has teammates waiting inside the area. And so it will be a corner. So the corner played into the box. And the header so near.
Well, he's in a great position. Technique's pretty good, but he just hits the woodwork.
Well, let's run the rule over the Preston North End starting 11. Pretty well balanced, this formation, Lee.
Yeah, it can be a 4-2-3-1 in the offensive mode, but it can also go back to a 4-5-1 when you're defending. The lone striker will be supported by the three just behind him, especially the number 10, who will be given a free roll.
Can they switch to an even higher gear? It has to be! Well, sadly, you've got to say, miles off target.
Well, if it had just bent it, or maybe just gone for a bit more accuracy. Instead, he went for the strong shot and he just fluffed his lines.
Lost possession. Decent progress with the ball at his feet. Well, the cross came over and a real need to get rid of the ball here. Now can they counter clinically? Well, visionary passing. Can he put it away? Oh, just off target.
Well, it was a wonderful break at speed and looked like they were going to capitalise on it. Not far off, Derek.
I believe there's been a change to the scoreline in the West Brom game. Alan?
It's a goal for West Bromwich Albion. 16 minutes played, 1-0.
Many thanks, Alan. Well, real difficulty keeping the ball. Dangerous looking through ball. King. That is a very fine challenge in difficult circumstances. And threading it forward. Fruitful looking attack. Oh, he's through here. It's got to be. Priority was to hang on to the ball, which he did. And providing width. Head over towards the back post. Well, a sloppy clearance. What can the opposition do with this? Short corner it is. Excellent challenge. Alan Brown with it. Maguire. Promising looking ball. Wonderful chance. And a goal it is, the opener in this game.
Well, keep it tight, that's what both managers would have been saying. But now the opening goal's gone in. Tactics have got to change.
1-0 then. A goal has gone in the Reading match. Alan McAnally has the details. Alan.
It's a goal for Reading. 31 minutes played. 1-0.
Regular updates from Alan McAnally along the way. Well, they keep working away, looking for passing lanes.
The hosts are struggling in terms of possession, but again, we've seen it before, we'll see it again. Their counter-attack play has been absolutely fantastic. Pace really hurts defences, and they've got that in abundance.
Richard. It's there for him! It wasn't far away from the target, Lee.
No, it was decent. Really, really decent chance for the lad. They'll keep pushing away to try and get that equaliser.
Fisher. That move looked as though it had genuine potential, but it's broken down. Well, someone has scored at the Stoke City Stadium. Let's hear about the goal. Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Stoke City. 42 minutes, please.
Well, they would have been in a decent position there, but offside.
Oh, what a wasted opportunity that is.
Pearson. Maguire with it. Will he find the net? Crucial intervention just then amid impending danger. Corner kick played in. Just unable to take advantage of that developing situation. Easy meet. Tremendous intuition to win it back. A chance then for the respective managers to address their charges. The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Alex Pritchard. King now. Dangerous looking attack. Daniel Johnson. Maguire. Johnson. And there might well be scope for them to counter-attack here. End product or not. And news coming through from the riverside where there has been a goal. Let's find out all about it from Alan McInally.
It's a second goal for Middlesbrough. 53 minutes played. 2-1.
Many thanks, Alan. Alan Brown with it. Beautifully weighted ball. On and on he goes. Crossing possibilities. It should be! Well, on the volley, that's not how he had planned it in his mind.
No, he certainly saw the ball going in a different direction than it went in.
Stearman. Another live game in the Championship coming your way on EA TV. It's Preston North End taking on Derby County.
Yeah, game after game, the season is relentless, but players just love to play. Give them a game any day of the week. That should be a belter.
Alan Brown with it. And there's been a goal at Craven Cottage. Alan McInally can provide the details. Alan.
It's a third goal for Fulham. 62 minutes played, 3-0.
Alan McInally keeping us right up to date. Just looking ahead to another game coming up for you from the Championship, live on EA TV. It's Huddersfield Town taking on Birmingham City.
Yeah, really looking forward to it. Always a great atmosphere in that stadium. Should be a really entertaining match. Well, look at those stats. Huddersfield certainly enjoying the lion's share of possession. However, after that, the coach will be disappointed with what they've produced. They need to be a little bit more clinical in front of goal.
Well, the fans enjoyed that pass. Oh, that's an interesting pass. Staunch rearguard action. Well, that's very smart defending, and now they have the ball again. And breaking at pace with menace. It might be on for them. He's had to go for it. Wins the ball.
Well, the ref will hear the crowd all right. We can hear him from here. He's taking some stick.
Making excellent progress with the ball at his feet. It's there for him. Almost what you might call a jaw-dropping save.
Oh, he's got no right to make that save. It's absolutely fantastic.
It didn't happen for them. I believe there's been a change to the scoreline in the West Brom game. Alan?
It's a third goal for West Bromwich Albion. It's been scored by Hal Robson-Kanu. Scored from a good way out with lots of bend and spin. The keeper couldn't get to it. 79 minutes played. 3-1.
Many thanks, Alan. Quick thinking to dispossess his opponent. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? He has time to play it over. Well, they seem to be onto something positive, but it faded away. And a substitution in the offing. Corner kick played in. It had an invitation attached, but he couldn't avail himself of the opportunity.
Well, just look at him. He thinks it's in, just wide. Well, the crowd have reacted to this effort the players are putting in. They just need to keep their concentration and the game should be theirs.
Grant, Juninho Bakuna, Christopher Schindler.
Number 8, Alan Brown.
They're showing a willingness to attack, as they must, given the circumstances. Time running out. Fine cross into the middle. Well, the clearance, half-hearted. That's it. The referee brings the action to an end.
Just a moment of your time. Thanks.
Hello and a warm welcome to the city of Derby. I'm Derek Ray here on the commentary box, and I'm joined for commentary by Lee Dixon. And we're on the cusp of bringing you live action from one of the most exciting leagues in Europe, the Championship. It's Derby County, and they take on Preston North End.
Yeah, thanks, Derek. Both teams will no doubt be looking for a quick start. So important to get focus from the off. Really looking forward to this. Hopefully it won't disappoint.
This attack looks highly promising. That move looked as though it had genuine potential, but it's broken down. Hughes. Running towards goal. Big chance it is. There it is, and just the ideal start. The opening goal of the game then. Right time for us to join Alan McInally, and I say that because a goal has been scored at the Riverside. Alan.
It's a goal for Middlesbrough. 8 minutes played, 1-0.
Alan McInally keeping us right up to date. No shortage of excitement. Level again. No wonder they're excited. Well, the earlier goal cancelled out. One apiece. It is to be a throw-in. Florian Josefsson, really good reading of the game to win possession back. Maguire with it. Oh, a nice looking pass. And he scored not once, but twice. They simply cannot stop him. And no wonder he's enjoying himself.
Obviously, it's a tap-in, Derek, but it's the patience in the box I like. A predator's instinct, just waiting for the ball to come to him.
So there we have it, 2-1. And a change to the scoreline at Craven Cottage, I'm hearing. A goal there. Alan McInally can tell us more.
It's a goal for Fulham. 17 minutes played, 1-1.
Regular updates from Alan McInally along the way. Cutting the ball back. And a goal it is! They lead by 2 now. Fully deserved. Shortage of goals on this match, 3-1. Well, that's very smart defending, and now they have the ball again. Hello? You've got to keep the ball a bit better than that. Fruitful looking attack. Smuggled away. Spot on with that tackle. It's with wisdom. Josefsson. And news of a goal in the Cardiff City game. Alan can fill us in.
It's a second goal for Cardiff City. 28 minutes played, 2-0.
Thanks as ever for the update, Alan. Wayne Rooney. They don't normally need a second invitation to give it a go on the counter. Well, that's one for them to pursue. The cross is on. It is a decent-looking attack here. Not really the ideal clearance. And they've only gone and applied that finishing touch.
Well, I do just love goals like this. On the breakaway, they soak up the pressure. You have to be organised when you haven't got the ball to break into the positions when you get the ball and hit the team on the counter-attack. And it's a clinical finish at the end of it as well.
Lawrence. An awful lot of green space to run into. And very deftly cut out.
As you can see, the visitors haven't had too much of the ball, but they won't mind with that. They're winning this game. They're sucking their opponents onto them. And with the pace they've got in midfield and up front, they're really causing problems.
Robbed them. Let's join Alan McInally. I say that because there's been a goal at Craven Cottage, Alan.
It's a second goal for Fulham. 42 minutes played, 2-1.
Alan McInally keeping us right up to date. Good-looking ball, there could be a chance now. Well, there it is, real resilience for you, having been two goals down. And level again here. This has been quite the roller coaster ride.
2 minutes of added time.
That's how to flummox the opposing defender. Well, that's how to do it inside your own penalty area. And with that, the first time. The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Gomez, still passing it around with authority. Is this the moment? And he's only gone and made it a hat-trick.
Well, when he's in this sort of mood, he's absolutely unstoppable. What a performance.
Well, if you enjoy high-scoring contests, this has been the game for you. I believe there's been a change to the scoreline in the West Brom game. Alan?
It's a goal for West Bromwich Albion. 48 minutes played. 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Lawrence. Shinny. Wayne Rooney. Well, more championship action for you to look forward to on EA TV. It's Derby County facing Fulham.
Yeah, I'm predicting a cracker there. Both teams will have a real go at each other, I'm sure.
Well, I must say, he acquitted himself well under pressure. Well, just couldn't keep the ball. A corner will ensue. Substitution time it is. He's driven in the corner. It comes to absolutely nothing. This looks promising. And here's Wayne Rooney. He must finish! And the post coming to the goalkeeper's aid. It's a cross towards the near post. Well, a sloppy clearance. What can the opposition do with this? Terrific block there. Can they get in behind them? And teammates to play it to. Can he get them level? Well, he took care of it defensively. They will now make use of the substitutes bench. And he's fired over the corner. Insufficient accuracy with the header, Lee.
Yeah, he got there as well. It was all about could he get it on target, but when you see how far he missed, wow.
Fisher on the ball. Barkhuizen. Well, more championship action for you to look forward to on EA TV. It's Preston North End taking on Hull City.
Yeah, that looks a great matchup, doesn't
it? Can he put it away? You enjoy high-scoring contests, this has been the game for you. And let's join Alan McInally with news of a goal that's been scored in the Barnsley game. Alan.
It's the second goal for Barnsley. 66 minutes played. 2-1.
Alan McInally with his finger on the pulse. Brown. Given away. Malone. Possession one. And that was a very fine read. They might be able to get in now. And that, a piece of goalkeeping you're going to see again and again and again. Corner kick played in. Punched away. Might really be able to trouble them here. With Sinclair, ball's gone. Rooney, not all that convincing defensively. And let's join Alan McInally because I'm hearing there's been a goal in the Reading match. Alan,
it's a third goal for Reading. 80 minutes played, 3-0.
Alan McInally keeping us right up to date. Deflected behind, corner forthcoming. Well, they've been getting the substitute ready and now they will make the personnel change.
Number 23, Dwayne Holmes.
And firing it into the area. You could see he was feeling the pressure, but gave it a go anyway. Not close, though.
Well, it was definitely worth the chance, just got the technique a little bit off.
Well, he's given opportunity, it is. It looked as though he almost forced the shot that time.
Well, it's okay shooting from there, but you have to test the keeper.
And the keeper's given it away inexcusably. Pretty close to worrying the scoreboard operator.
No, it's worth a try though, but when he looks at the position he is in, he'll be disappointed he didn't hit the target.
So a throw in here. Malone. It's with Lawrence. Just a couple of minutes left for play. Shinny. Waghorn. Holmes. And 3 minutes will be added on for stoppages.
3 minutes of added time.
Oh, a nice looking pass. Useful ball to the near post. And the referee's whistle, that is the end of the story.